and the CEO will be better for us. Yeah. Look at it. Ghana football started declining from 2014 after the Brazil debacle. And the fact that they have one, I don't know what to say.
You want to talk about football as in what exactly?
I mean, national team club. National team, club level, I mean everything around Ghana football became problematic.
I think the club level bit.
Yeah, club level, our teams.
I agree.
Our teams.
Because even with the national team level, we got to the semi-final of the AFCON in 2017.
We got there with, you know, some kind of upper towards the national team from Ghanaians.
Yeah, when you say that, I agree. But when you say that,
I'm talking about the
semi final.
And then a lot of, you know, things that were betraying the team, like, were confirmed to us by the Anas Exposé, right? And we also officiating, it was a problematic, it was confirmed. Official.
It's not different now.
Well, for now we don't have the evidence.
I've got cheating. Because when you mention it,
yes, I mean, yes, officiating might not be the best, but there are a lot of initiatives, you know, to correct the imperfection within the officiating cycles. Now, within that time, then, when I'm asking expose came, before my LSU came, and then we have this new administration, I came to go back. You know, within a short period, COVID set. So I want to judge him based on that view. So I'm judging him as a COVID era. Looking at what he has brought on board in terms of commercialization, innovations, visibility, and all those things. I'm equally not discrediting for the failure of any of the national teams, you know, to make progress. World Cup bonus, I think the collective of what I always maintain that Ghana's collective to win a World Cup is a political decision. But everyone, the political meeting, right from the first era, the Jamil's era, Mohammed's era. So those who keep giving credit to the everybody that are doing this, they when it comes to this qualification of the team, particularly the ladies, I think yes, there could be some official evidence as well. But let us look at it. Players come with their ages, just like any other sport, with documentation. It's difficult to blame officially.
Administrators want to scrutinize whatever form that
I'm scrutinizing. That's why. No, look at it.
So somebody did a poor job of scrutinizing.
That's why it passed
for 6 years.
Yes, that's why let us give credit to the system where biometric registration, digitization of our system is coming in. You get me? Mm-hmm. There are a lot of compressions all over in the system.
Mm-hmm.
It's difficult to blame, you know, officially.
Mm-hmm.
The first issue about age that I am aware of in Ghana football started from 1985. When Ezekiel Emu and Joao, what is my mind from the first black, the set light, which Ghana was in the big Togo. And a Ghanaian coach, Williams, former Blaster player, who was putting over at the time. Did a meeting, that was the first time. And you couldn't blame the air player at the time. It has continued during the incident, which is the famous Blaster. Cameroon also had issue with our age. And it was difficult to blame the management at the time. So in the same way, I will not attribute any problem to the current dispensation. And I will vote for vote, and I agree that there should be proper,
proper checks.
Proper checks around. Because that's why I always believe that the government sport should always be school based. So to reduce this kind of FCTN process,
okay.
Look at the national team, black tax, and all those things. What kind of problem you are having now? The countries that are making it now. Have this development years back. Senegal, as we are looking at, has also had their own up and downs. But because of deliberate systematic planning that are coming. So why I'm not opportunity and why I don't do the CHO? I think 2.5 years we must be. That's a mess, this administration will be a smooth takeoff whatever,
I mean, like I said, briefly,
some of the messages from Uncle George's camp. Some of them more of the populist talks, and then
I haven't seen any official money.
No, I mean, when we talk about Ghanaian fans' inability to attract quality players from the local, is that that was one of the problems?
I mean, who said that?
I mean, it's one of the messages.
I'm struggling to understand that. I'm saying that from the message.
As he submitted it from the last time.
Did he say that?
Yes, he said that. Yes.
Jerome.
And they are saying that people say to the fact that the system, the football system, you know, is just trapped. So clubs cannot attract the top of our migration and all those things. Migration from the football is due to, it's a West African problem. It's not necessarily about.
Okay.
So I didn't hear that. Let us have a message. Well, we can digest. We are not voting.